subject that I'm studying. So, but from what I personally, these are just things that I've learned from personal experiences. It also depends on your chart, your birth chart, your natal chart. It depends on where the planets were. If retrograde is going to affect you, and some of them are to what degree it's going to affect you, and what subjects in your life it's going to affect you in. From what I've personally learned that retrograde, it's basically it's one way of the universe to basically show you things in your life that you're giving life to, and you're basically just wasting it, because, you know, these things you're helping grow, or, you know, you're giving energy to, they're not meant to be in your life. So a lot of things will come to an end during phases of Mercury being in retrograde. There are also repeating patterns. A lot of the times you'll notice, okay, well, especially with me, I noticed, and I'm still breaking them, there are patterns, or just in different aspects or different areas of my life, there are patterns that I kept repeating, and it was just causing the same thing, man. I actually, about a year and a half ago, I used to say it a lot, is basically the definition of insanity, which is basically trying to do something over and over again, and doing it the same way, expecting different results. It's insanity. It's not going to happen. So retrograde, it's one way of the universe, basically, you know, it's going to bring them into the light and highlight them. And basically, it's the universe's way of saying, you know, hey, no. But just also remember, everything that falls away, it's because it's making new space for newer things, for better things, for things that you have either manifested or things that, you know, they're coming to you because of all the good you put out, you know. Travel. Check your batteries, check your cars, check your gas, check your tires, check to see, make sure you have extra tires, check to make sure that spare tire is actually okay and it can be used, or your donut. You know, make sure you have a jug of water in your car. You know, all these small things that typically you normally would not worry about. During the time of Mercury being in retrograde, these are things you should check, especially before going on a trip or a road trip, for example. Traveling trip, make sure, you know, you've packed everything. Make sure everything is set up. You know, call a couple hours or a couple of days advance, you know, before you're supposed to leave to do all these things. You know, call and check to see how everything is going, because Mercury rules over travel, communication, those go hand in hand, so things tend to go awry. The first time I actually realized and started reading about Mercury and the effects it has, I just got a computer, I think it was 18, I just got my first computer, and the hard drive fried itself. Luckily it was still on warranty, so I sent it back. They couldn't figure out what was wrong with it, so they sent me a new one. I put that one in, and my charger for my laptop fried itself. I bought a new charger, ordered it, it came in, it worked for like a week, it fried itself. So, you know, or phones, memory cards, if you're sending any emails, if you're a writer and you're writing something, or if you're in, you know, college or school and you're having to do a report or something like that, make sure it's backed up, because small things like your computer may accidentally glitch and reset itself and you lose everything. Make sure things are backed up. With communication, normally it's miscommunications. I know with me and my partner James, it's miscommunications. And before then, like, some of our arguments that we've had, they were over literally just, he thought I said this, or I thought I heard that. So it's small, simple things that, you know, you can do, and it makes it, I guess, this fucking crazy ass ride. more durable. You know, it's more survival. There are stones to wear, or to carry with you, if you have anxiety and if you're very anxious a lot, so you tend to, you know, wind up thinking thoughts. Eventually, you can manifest the thoughts that you don't want. Smoky quartz, on top of it being a great grounding stone, it also, because of the smokiness, it can be programmed to filter out the thoughts that you don't want to manifest, and filter through the thoughts you do want to manifest. There was something else that I had a list, and of course I forgot to freaking actually bring the list with me, of course. But my partner, he works at a mechanic shop. Last week, I think it was, earlier this week, they got 3 or 4 batteries, brand new, off the truck, that didn't work. So, like, he's actually starting to see, and then, he had a day the other day, like, everybody up there at work was just, there was so much confusion going around, but he was, like, he realized and remembered that it was, you know, Mercury's in retrograde. These things will happen: miscommunication, confusion, you know. And because he realized it and saw that it was happening, he made sure, and he, like, you know, made sure that he was hearing everything right, that he was making sure what he was saying couldn't be confused, you know. Dating wise, it's normally not the best time to go on dates during Mercury retrograde. Normally, because, and also this is another thing with the retrogrades, is with, like, contracts and buying a new car, getting in an apartment, during retrograde, it can kind of be an illusion. So, in other words, these sweet deals that sound way too good to be true, 9 times out of 10, if it's in retrograde, if it's happening in retrograde, it's too good to be true. And when Mercury goes direct, all the illusions and everything else that, you know, looked a certain way, or, you know, was a certain way during the retrograde, will actually come to be revealed for what it really is. So I'm trying to think of an example that didn't happen to me. There's one where my mom, actually, she was going to get a car, and we had, like, 1 or 2 more weeks left of the retrograde, and this was last year, actually, and I was like, don't get the car. She went up there, and she was all cool, and she was like, oh, it's just an amazing deal, you know, I just had to get it. And I was like, okay. Well, about 2 or 3 weeks later, when Mercury went direct, she was constantly having to go back up to the shop so they could tweak this or tweak that with the car, because these small little issues that they didn't see, or, you know, could not be seen 2 or 3 weeks ago when she first got it, was revealed then. That's basically how it works. It basically, if you were to go on a date during retrograde, and then say you went back on a date with the same person during direct, it could be like you were basically dating a completely different person. So those are things to, you know, and again with this, now I wanted to emphasize too that not everything that sounds too good to be true during retrograde is. It's not always, you know, some things are real. Like, if you get offered an amazing job, you know, go with your instinct, go with what you feel, go with your intuition, basically. There we go, that was the word. And see, like, again, that goes back, though, to, for one, what you've done prior to the retrogrades, and, of course, what other planets are going, or what they're other doing, and it also depends on your natal chart. So, again, these are just little tips that I've learned along the way, and no, you do not have to be a witch or a practitioner or anything like that for the planets and retrogrades and directs and all the eclipses.